Hey, Jay Grams here at the Volo Museum Auto Sales. Today we're going to tour our showrooms and we're going to be on the hunt for convertibles. I don't know about you, but here in Chicago, the weather is warming up and it seems to be convertible season is on everybody's brain. I'm sitting in one of my favorite convertibles we have. It's a 66 Chevy Impala. And it's loaded. It's a 327, power steering, power disc brakes, air conditioning, the rally wheels, the red lines. And you gotta check out the interior here. It has the Strato bench seat. They're like two bucket seats attached in the middle. So it has an armrest. And you wanna sit by your sweetheart, there you go. But check this out, a factory clock on the dash that's working, AM FM radio. Tachometer, the original style four-speed shifter. We got power windows, even a power seat. Check this out, tilt wheel. But here's where it gets really cool. Woo-hoo-hoo. You never see a telescopic wheel in an Impala. It's got the four speakers, it's got the floor mats, deluxe seat belts. The list just goes on and on with this car. So anyway, we have 247 cars in stock right now. About 50 of them are convertibles. That should be, what, 1 in 5 is a convertible. Let's go looking for them. Let me grab my coffee. I see one over here in the convertible, in the corner, a couple of them. This is our 1957 Chevy. Known as the Crate 57. This car is new. New frame, new metal, new body, new interior, new everything. New crate motor. This is a documented build. Really a lot going for this car right here. If you want to drive a new 57 Chevy, it's literally what it is. If you want to wow everybody on the streets, how about a Chrysler 300? That's the performance car with the Hemi, with the two carburetors, all leather upholstery, nut and bolt restored like jewelry. Imagine going down the road with that top down and big tail fins up in the air. Okay, we better go look. Got a few more to find. Boy, it doesn't seem like 1 in 5 are convertibles. These are all hard tops. Got another 57 Chrysler. This is not the 300, but still has the New Yorker, still has the Hemi engine in it, and still just as gorgeous, drop dead beautiful. Look at them sparkling wire wheels. This is the extremely rare 68. I think it's a Parisienne. It's a Canadian car. Now, they use the Pontiac body, but they put Chevy drivetrain from the factory. This is fully documented. 1 of 3 made, 427 with a 4-speed in a big full-size car. That will get people talking. You probably go to a Chevy show or a Pontiac show. And we got a couple more in this building. Actually, we got a few of them lined up over here. For starters, we got a really nice example of a T-Bird, tuxedo black, 55 Ford Thunderbird, power steering, power windows, power seat. It is a convertible, but it also has the hard top that bolts right on there. Not bolts on, but clamps on, and it has the soft top behind the seat. This is a dialed in sweetheart of a car. Loaded up. That black paint's like a mirror. A couple little neat features, the chrome eyebrows, and then the, I guess, fog lamps built right into the bumper. Those are unique features you don't see too often. 32 Ford Roadster. This is an eye-popping little hot rod. Very meticulously built. Even has the mother-in-law seat in the back. Now it's Corvette time. How about a 1973 Corvette Roadster? This was a 1-year design, rubber bumper in front, chrome bumper in back, what makes this one special, it's a numbers match 454, a four-speed transmission, and it's all numbers matching. Great colors. When we posted the video, you guys all love the colors on the car, and I agree. Known as the upside down bathtub, a little 58 Porsche Speedster replica. These original cars may bring $200,000, $300,000, $500,000. This is a replica that actually has a genuine Porsche engine in it. So for a fraction of the price, you can get a lot of enjoyment out of that little Speedster. Keeping with the foreign theme, we got a 1960 MGA, nice little red sports car. You can tool around with this and have some fun. These European cars are just a whole different feel, a whole different experience than the American muscle cars. Still fun to shift, they make a cool sound. Yeah, another Thunder Chicken, a 1957. Ford Thunderbird. Nice older restoration, has some really great features. You come over here, I'll show you something that's really cool. The biggest problem with the T-Bird, especially as we get older, is getting in and out of them. The steering wheel is close to the seat. Well, this is the same steering wheel, but it's made smaller. And this one's on a tilt column. I think it's the first T-Bird I've ever seen here with a tilt wheel. So getting in and out is a breeze. This also has rack and pinion steering. They've added air conditioning, a stereo, seat belts, power disc brakes. So this has all sorts of upgrades to make it a great driver. You can't go wrong with the 69 Camaro convertible. This is a nice SS350 with air conditioning, power steering, power brakes. The white interior stays nice and cool. The orange exterior will make you look cool. I was talking about the sporty little MG. Well, if that's not quite enough for you, this is exhilarating. I always use that word to describe these. The roar of the pipes, and you're sitting down low and the pipes are right there. You can reach out and touch them. And you're shifting those gears, hearing that roar. It's like a go-kart on steroids. These things are just awesome. And they're actually very well built. There's quite a structure underneath that fiberglass. This one here has got a 427, an actual 427 big block motor in it, with a four speed. Fun, fun, fun. Well, we got to hit some other buildings, find some more convertibles. Bam, we walk into showroom two. What's the first car we see? A 67 GTO convertible. Yeah, I apologize about the colors, red with white. That's just amazing, beautiful. I think this one has four-wheel disc brakes has been added to it. It's a four-speed transmission, 400 motor. Just picture yourself cruising down the road. The whole family can enjoy it. All right, there's convertibles behind us here. Another 57 Chrysler. We have three of them. We brought them back from Sweden. As my father just said, you know what, these cars are incredible. One car was offered to us and we ended up buying all three. Bringing them back to the United States. Nut and bolt restored. '55 Chevy, this thing's loaded to the gills. The bumper guards are all optional. Believe it or not, an oil filter was optional. It's a power pack motor with the four barrel, power steering, power brakes, windshield washers. Nice older body off frame restoration. It's got the dual spotlights, the traffic viewfinder, Wonder Bar radio, a tissue dispenser, floor mats, an Autronic Eye dims the headlights, seat belts were added, and then we even got a convertible for your grandchild, right there. Go cruising together. Well, I guess a Land Cruiser would qualify as a convertible. It's got no top. Well, it has a convertible top. It's not on it right now. It easily installs. You got the jump seats in the back. You got four-wheel drive. A little bit bigger footprint than the Jeep, so they do handle better. It's a six-cylinder motor. It's bulletproof, they say. This one's nut and bolt restored, 15,000 actual miles. Now, if you want to be the top dog on your street or have the best car in the show, this is it right here, 65 GTO, a few $100,000 build. Absolutely stunning car, the color, the wheels, all upgraded brakes, suspension, you know, cloth top, custom four bucket seat interior, front to back console, overdrive automatic, so it's easy to drive. And gives you 700 horsepower, that should be enough. It's a 565 Dart engine. Look how it's all polished. Hydro boost brakes, that car is awesome. Oh boy, it might be all the convertibles in here today. Let's go showroom 3. Baseball, apple pie, and a Mustang convertible. 1965, 289 V8. Just finished a ground up restoration. Great colors. V8 automatic. Easy car to drive, easy to maintain. Oh, here's a 69 Chevelle convertible. Real slick metallic silver. Got the wheels, the stance. It's a real cool car from a collection, from a collector. And for a motor, 454, has the overdrive automatic. So you can just go cruising all day long. 57 Oldsmobile. This is a top dog. 57 Olds, 98, tri-power under the hood, and factory air conditioning. Find those two items in a convertible. Good luck with that. Spotlight, the automatic headlight dimmer, the traffic light finder, genuine leather upholstery, seat belts were added. I call it a swim platform on the back there, like a boat would have. That's for the Continental kit. Another beautiful example, a 56 Ford Sunliner. Got the cattle guards up front, that's what they nicknamed those. The wire wheel hubcaps with the big white wall tires. This one also has a set of spotlights, and then the colors, the black with the red and white, stunning. Another swim platform in the back of this one too. Flashy and trashy, that's what the 50s cars were all about. See the exhaust coming right out through the bumper. Now a muscle car, a 66 Ford Fairlane GTA, concourse restored, on a rotisserie, nut and bolt done to factory specs. That's got the ESCO 390 motor, factory red car. We got another convertible hiding over here. 1954 Ford Crestline Sunliner. Again, colors black with the red and white interior. Just a beautiful car. This is loaded for a 54 Ford. It's the V8, power steering, power brakes, power top, the wire basket hubcaps, all sorts of extra trim on the outside, even a tissue dispenser. This is a sweetheart of a car. It just purrs along. It just smooth as can be. And we got two more convertibles in this building. Tell you what, you might be able to have this car for free. Jewel Osco is a large grocery store chain in our area. They bought this car, they're gonna give it away. So if you live nearby, or I guess if you don't live nearby, Jewel Osco will be looking for this car as a giveaway very soon. They do that, I think, about once a year. They buy a car from us and give it away. And here's a car that's sometimes overlooked. It's a Buick GS. It has great style. Look at that back bumper, the trunk, the design. I think it's great. It's a Buick GS 400. Great colors. Look at this body line that goes all the way down. It's like stealth looking, this car. Factory air conditioning in a convertible, one owner for 29 years. And here's another convertible. How did I miss this? This car is absolutely stunning. The black and the white and the wheels and the stance. That's a 6-speed manual transmission. Just picture your hand on this shifter with an LS motor under the hood. Imagine the fun you could have with this car right here. But you probably won't hit the buy it now and you'll let somebody else have all the fun. That's okay. Let's go to the other building and find some more. No, you didn't get transferred into one of my Let's Go for a Spin videos. I just peeked in here. This is a car I will be videoing later today. 1967 Corvette convertible. Yeah, that top folds down. It's a 327 350 horse, original number match, documented with the window sticker, 4-speed car. Pretty sharp looking car right there. You'll see that video in the next couple days. All right, got a few more buildings to go through. We found the top dog right here. This is the title holder of the highest horsepower from any production car back in the muscle car era. And yes, you can argue this one had more, but the most advertised horsepower was the LS6 with 450 horsepower. This one is a gorgeous color, misty turquoise. That's the factory color. It is built to LS6 specs, has genuine LS6 motor and block and heads and intake, working cowl induction flapper hood. Has the M22 Rock Crusher heavy duty 4-speed, frame off restored, not even 200 miles on it since it's been finished. Gorgeous car. This video hit recently and everyone talked about the color. Two different opposite ends of the spectrum here. We've got an 01 Camaro with all the goodies, LS motor, power seat, leather, air. You just touch the key and it starts. So that's reliability with performance and style. And then a 55 Buick Century. Gorgeous car. It looks this nice underneath the car. Nut and bolt off body restored. And that's where the value is. You try getting anything done lately, you try getting work on a car, on your house, on your boat, you're gonna pay through the nose. This restoration would cost you $150,000. All glove soft leather. Look at all the chrome. Here it is, a finished car, ready to go. Right behind us is a 69 Firebird, also nut and bolt restored on a rotisserie. Beautiful dark fathom green with the pearl white interior. Great color combination. Oh yeah, it's a stick shift. That's a 4-speed. Early head-up display, the tachometer on the hood. Cut across, I spot two convertibles here. Prowler. This is a Chip Foose design. It was kind of modeled after like a 32, 34 Roadster that you would see back in the day with the tall wheels in the back, the tachometer on the steering column. This one's a 99 Prowler with 324 actual miles. It's red with chrome wheels. I don't think you can find a better one. Then the car behind it has a lot of star power. It's an 06 Mercedes CLK 350. This was Britney Spears' personal car. And it's not just a car that she owned at one time and her name's on the title. This is a car that she was in the news with a lot. Little fender benders, tickets, all sorts of different scenarios. This car is as famous as she is. Well, maybe almost. I see another Firebird convertible. This is updated with the LS Corvette motor. It's actually updated with a lot of stuff. 5-speed manual, air, fuel injected, of course, power steering, power disc brakes, custom suspension, posi tilt, power windows, power locks, console, sport seats, tachometer, gauges. The list of options actually gets cut off because there wasn't any more room on our sheet. Go to volocars.com and that's where you can read all the specs on each. Each car has over about 100 pictures of video, description, prices, financing. It's all on the website, and absolutely feel free to contact us with any of your questions. Oh, a couple of Maseratis here. I think these are a lot of bang for the buck. Ferrari motor. A lot of people say this is the best sounding car in the business. This thing's got a sound that's just awesome. You can actually look up the individual videos of these cars if you want to hear it. Great Italian style, a sporty interior, all the luxury. I love silver with red, but I am head over heels in love with this red with the tan interior. This car is killer. Just look at that thing. And again, I drove this home one night and I felt like I was driving in a $1 million car. Very possibly, probably the world's best thing. 1974 Volkswagen thing. That's got a 2,276 cc stroker motor with a turbo. This is a performance car. This car will hit it and get it. Complete rotisserie restoration. Honest to goodness, $100,000 invested in building this. This was a magazine feature car. I love the thing. These doors actually lift right off. You can have all four doors off. You can have the windshield folded down. You can put the top on it. It's got a stereo system. Check that out. It's been to a couple Volkswagen shows and it was the star of the show. This is cool. And then we got good old Sweet Pea here. Oh boy, 49, 50, 51, something like that. Ford, just a sweetheart of a car. George, who manages the showroom, says, you know, this car never lets me down. You hit the button, it fires up and it purrs. Genuine leather upholstery. And I think that about wraps it up. We have another red Prowler. If you don't want 300 miles, we have one with 2,000 miles on it. Same thing, red with chrome wheels. So take your pick or buy them both. They have a his and hers. Go to volocars.com. We still have cars in our shop that are being processed. We have warehouse buildings. Our website's literally being updated daily, actually more like hourly, volocars.com. And subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click the bell icon. You'll be notified when the new ones are posted. Thanks for watching.